and edible coatings and films of animal products. So as all of you know that earlier food packaging is basically playing just a passive role. But now the era has been changed. Nowadays, it is an increasingly interesting topic to incorporate either antioxidants or antioxidants, antimicrobials or any materials which can improve the nutritional value and property of the food product that is containing within that package through the package itself. Because once if we want to incorporate any antioxidant or any antimicrobial directly into the food product, it leads to a big problem. So that is the reason why if you choose a packaging material which can transform these antimicrobial or antioxidants, which can effectively deliver these things into the food product slowly, that would be of great interest nowadays. Another important feature here is we can reduce the external packaging. We can reduce the plastic packaging, quantity of the plastic that can be used. One thing to remember here is edible films or coatings can never replace the petrochemical based packaging. We have to use it. But when we can reduce the inner primary packaging material, whatever we are using for that. And apart from that, nowadays agriculture people are far ahead than using these things in veterinary, because we are applying it in animal products. But already for coating of apples, cut apples, it is already in vogue. They are in the market nowadays. So with this growing interest, there is another interest to extend the shelf life that essential oils, which are natural, generally regarded as safe materials, grass materials, these things can be incorporated into these edible packaging coatings or films. Next please. Keeping these things in view, with the hypothesis that if we are with the hypothesis that there will be no difference in the shelf life of the food subjected to incorporation of these grass materials into the edible packaging or coated or films, and there won't be any quality improvement in the meat food, with these null hypothesis we have developed some coatings and films. So primarily we have selected three types of coatings. One is with the basis of cornstarch, and the other is using sodium alginate as the primary base material, and the third one is the corn gene film. To study this, every time we have done it separately. Corn starch base, and into the corn starch we have incorporated clove oil and cinnamon oil, each separately at 1% level, and into the sodium alginate film. These are all, as all of you know that these are polymers, and into these polymers we have incorporated green tea extract and grapeseed extract into sodium alginate. So this is the procedure for preparation of, if you are going for a coating solution. Here we have used for corn starch and sodium alginate films, glycerin is the plasticizer. Because these are the edible materials, they have to be first hydrolyzed, and then you have to add some plasticizer to make it like a plastic. Okay, for this, glycerin is being added as a plasticizer for corn starch and for sodium alginate, but corn gene does not go well with glycerin. It is the PEG what we have chosen. Here for initially either the corn starch or the sodium alginate, after trial and several combinations of percentages, for corn starch we have arrived at a 4% level, and for sodium alginate we have arrived to use it at 2% weight by volume level. Both these things were hydrolyzed, and after hydrolyzing, glycerin was added at 4% level, and we have coated a meat product without addition of antioxidants, that is one treatment, with the addition of 1% clove oil after addition of glycerin, that is the second treatment, and cinnamon oil is the third treatment.
Likewise, after hydrolyzing with sodium alginate hydrolyzation, we have added glycerin to 4% level, that is the T1, and we have added 1% green tea extract, that is T2, and grapeseed extract, that is T3.
This is corn gene film is almost like a, we can get a film like just like a plastic material, but the procedure is somewhat different when compared to the sodium alginate or cornstarch base. PEG suits well than glycerol, and it has to be again cooled and dried, and for after preparation of this material, we have gone for two things. Whether to test the capacity of these coating materials to form films, we have casted the film with the same material and wrapped the product in that. And the other method is to dip the product directly into that coating material. So we have prepared the product for coating. This is we have dipped the
product into that, and afterwards it will be drained and dried for some time in the hot air oven.
Next, please. So these are the coated mutton balls with antioxidants and without antioxidants, with clove oil incorporated coating, wherein cinnamon oil is incorporated. Here, one thing I want to tell you is, we have not directly incorporated the clove oil or cinnamon oil into that one. We have to via encapsulation. We have gone for process encapsulation of the cinnamon oil or clove oil, because to avoid that pungent smell. So encapsulation was done and to the procedure, and after encapsulated clove oil containing corn starch based material has been coated over the mutton balls. So these are all the common product quality testing methodologies, approved methodologies to test the, we have coated the meat product, and we have prepared the films also, as well as we have wrapped the meat product in that films, and we have tested the product for that proximate composition, pH, water loss analysis, thiobarbituric acid reactive substance values, peroxide values, and the microbial quality, as well as the quality of the films. Next please. Antimicrobial, we have tested the antimicrobial activity of the film also. We have dried the films, and these are the films what we have developed. First one is the congene films, and next is the meat ball which is being wrapped in that congene film. Next is the sodium alginate film, and next is the alginate film with grapeseed extract. This is the meat balls, the nuggets which are wrapped in the congene film and alginate film with grapeseed extract. Next please. Whatever the film or the coating material what we have used, they were proved better than the controls. Okay. Coated ones are better than controls in any case, and the results were analyzed through SPSS as usual, and the cornstarch, either the cornstarch or sodium alginate or congene, whatever the film you choose, coating is proved better in animal product, for animal product, than film wrapping. So films are not useful for the processed food material. That in any case of coating, here either we store it under refrigeration or under the frozen situation. This
is the control, and this is the coating without any antioxidant or any antioxidant. This is the two treatments. Okay, one with clove oil and the other one cinnamon oil. But here pH, at any point of time, it is,
the pH is lower and the TBRS values are lower. But finally, next please. Here also, in under frozen situation also, like the peroxide values are lower when compared to the control, and when compared to the control, the coated ones are better. When compared to the coated ones, the coatings with anti-GRS materials are better. They are having low peroxide values. Even the microbial counts, as we have used the clove oil and cinnamon oil, grapeseed extract, green tea extract, these are proven materials which are having antimicrobial properties along with the antioxidant properties. So the total plate count was also less when compared to the other products. Next please. Water loss was, you can observe, very big difference is there in the water loss under freezing condition, frozen condition, because water loss is the one which will make the product, if the water in the product, it gets loose, the product becomes dry, it becomes unpalatable. Water loss is at a very low level for all the coated products. Next please. And as well as the sensory quality is being maintained to a greater level. Here you can see,
these are the treatments. Sensory quality at the end of the storage period is high for the coated ones, as well as under freezing situation also, the sensory quality of the coated product is better when compared to the uncoated ones. Next please. These are the results of
Results showed the same trend for sodium alginate. These are the results with sodium alginate. Next, please. So, here I want to conclude that incorporation of edible coatings with essential oils or antioxidant materials had a significant effect in reducing the fat oxidation levels and microbial infiltration into any meat food product, and their shelf life can be extended, and the edible coatings incorporated with these grass materials can play an active role as a part of active packaging systems. And these edible films can be formed and can be used as active packaging materials on the food, but whatever the base materials that we have taken, they are not showing any good effect. That is a choosing phenomenon, no sir. So that's why the material what I had chosen, they are better as coating materials than films, but films can be made, but not having a good effect. Thank you. Okay.